my only aim is that after going through this class, you all should be trained BLS. Do you understand this word is trained BLS? Trained in basic life skills. So next time once you go, you can actually teach other people how to do that. So to start with, this is basic life support. Anybody who knows what is basic life support? So, basic life support is a, you know, procedure where we save a patient, save a person who is in front of you, you feel dying. And dead also. You can attempt both basic life support on anybody which you are feeling not responding. Understood? Not responding. Word not responding is the most important thing about the basic life support. Okay? So the objectives of this class is firstly how to assess that person is either dying or that is the most important, because if you first step is wrong, then the problem is that you will be doing the wrong thing to the wrong person. That may harm. Okay? So first and foremost thing is to assess the person is dying or not. Right? And other things we will be showing. Will you tell what is the difference between airway and breathing?
Airway is the nostrils.
Okay.
Breathing is to inhale
and exhale. Very good, very right. Very, very right. Okay? So airway is the path from path where we are taking the air, and the breathing is the air where it is going and what it is doing. Understood? Both are different things in terms of handling a emergency. Okay? Why we will need to revive a dying or dead person? Why? Ever you thought of? Why do you need to revive? Why you can't to take them to hospital? Why you can't? Why you cannot, you know, ask somebody to help, some doctor? Why you can't wait? That is the most important thing. Why we can't wait? You have to do the job immediately, then and there. Anybody knows? What is the most important part in your body? No. Who is regulating your heart?
Brain.
Yes. That is what it is. So this all the hue and cry and learning, teaching, everything to save your brain. Got it? And why? How heart becomes an important thing? Because brain is, the blood circulation in the brain goes by heart. So as soon as heart goes down, your blood in brain will stop. Got it? And blood will stop, then what will happen? Oxygen will not be there to survive. Main work of blood is oxygen. So oxygen to the brain is the most important thing. That is why we don't have time to wait for a doctor or to take the person to the hospital. Again, somebody say, tell me, why we don't have time? We have hours in life, we have, you know, days. Yeah, tell me.
We can't wait because if we wait, the person will die.
Yeah, die because neural tissue. Do you understand? Neural tissue. Brain is full, is made up of neural tissue. The surviving time of neural tissue, the brain tissue, is very, very less. It is lesser than any organ in the body. Kidney you can wait. Kidney you can wait even years before they call air. They keep getting shut. The shutting down of kidney and any other organ is very gradual. They cannot go in just like that. Even same way with the heart. Once they collapse, they have, you know, still the capacity to survive for some time. But brain and the neural tissue, they don't have any time and they don't have any capacity also. Once they are going to die, then they are dead. Got it? So our main aim regarding this, doing this emergent activity, taking decision, and everybody on this earth should know this activity, whosoever is in like adulthood should know this activity. Reason is one, to save the brain. Okay, so brain time, to remain alive after any sudden injury in the sense cardiac arrest or something, trauma, cardiac arrest, is anybody can tell me? Guess, any guesses? How much time brain will give you to remain active? Yes. Any wild guess?
10 seconds.
10 seconds is less. 3 minutes. So see how important you are when somebody is dying in front of you. 3 minutes you have to take decision. If within 3 minutes you are able to, you know, do your job properly, the person can be as healthy and hearty as you. Even he is already dead. In 3 minutes, if you have taken decision, you have done your job of BLS, he can be revived to the life as anybody else would have done it. Any doctor, any big hospital, any big machine would have done it. You can do that. 3 minutes, okay? So 3 minutes is golden period. And then another period, which is where, you know, brain may have little damage, but still it can continue, you know, showing some activity or some more activities, 30 minutes. Got it? Within 3 minutes you do it, it is the best golden period. In that, if it, a person is able to revive, then they can be totally normal to the life. And 30 minutes is another golden period where if they are revived, then they can survive. Revive and survive are different. Revive means they will be the totally normal. In 30 minutes and even a longer time, they are able to revive, they will survive, they will live. They may have some damage to the brain later. So best period is 3 minutes, and after that whatever period, whenever you can do, it's always better. Okay? So my main idea is to tell how serious this business is. All of you guys understood? Because till the time I make you understand the seriousness of business, telling, practicing is not going to make any difference. Everybody understood the seriousness, how important and how serious it is. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, what you are going to encounter is either a sudden cardiac arrest, like you are in cinema or in public place, you are seeing somebody is having a chest pain and just collapsing on the ground, one, and second is trauma. These are the two main important people you are going to come across. Trauma in the sense, a person met with an accident, too much of bleeding is there, so later on they get the shock. Got it? So these are the two kind of people which you are going to encounter in your normal day-to-day life, where you may need it to do this BLS. Okay. So this is the heart, and as soon as you get person, you make the person lie down. Early CPR. So what do you do? Buy the time. By doing this, you buy the time other professionals, medical professional to work. Before any medical, a proper help to reach, you are doing some activity, some work where it can be added on and the final patient is going to survive. And this is, after that we do early defibrillation, and post resuscitation is once you revive or the person is survived, later on you have to take. This is again sequence of procedures where how do you tackle a person who is unconscious and dead. So this is the sequence. Firstly, approach the safety. This is very important. Sometimes we forget. If a whole house is burning and you are supposed to go inside and, you know, save somebody, so what will you do? You are seeing some dead patient. You should not start reviving. Then 3 minutes is not important. That time first thing, first and foremost, he is always there. Earthquake is there. Then what will you do? You will keep sitting under a roof and you will start reviving? No. So first and foremost thing is approach safety. Safety of yourself and safety of the person. That is most important. That algorithm, it remains same for same for everybody and anywhere. And with any activity or any event like earthquake, drowning, burning, like any fire. These are the hazards you may come across. So that algorithm is this. First approach the safety, then check responses. That is what we are going to teach you. How to check response that patient is either dying or dead. Because that is important. If person is not dying or dead, you are just assuming and you start with BLS or basic life support, then it may break his ribs or you know, it may deteriorate further. A person may deteriorate, right? Shout for help. Alone you can't do long. CPR is a tough, it is a strenuous job. So shout for help. First you start and then always look if somebody is around. Help, help, help. Okay? That also will be our sergeant is going to teach you how to shout for help.
If excess of water goes into lungs while drowning and if we have kept out the person, what will we do?
CP? Just put the patient on the board or whatever, the flat surface, and just press, bring, press, and bring. Same for everybody. Now the lungs will come, that water will also come out, and by doing the breathing, she will take the breath out. Nobody. Drowning, fire, anything. Wherever you are feeling their pulse is missing, go see. We'll show you how to do. Anybody else? What is full form of CPR? Cardiopulmonary resuscitation. Cardio, we are pressing it and breathing. Pulmonary. Cardiopulmonary resuscitation. So, basic life support has another name, that is called GPR. We do the cardiac work and we do the lung work. So, both, by doing both, we are saving breath. That's the basic concept. Okay?
जब आप देखेंगे चेस्ट पे तो इन्फ्लेट होगा, इनके आसपास रेस्पिरेशन चल रहा है तो इन्फ्लेट करेगा चेस्ट को और यहाँ से आपको वॉइस सुनाई देगी. ठीक है,
दिस इज द टू वे, वन यू आर फीलिंग इट एंड आफ्टर दैट हाउ द पर्सन इज ब्रीदिंग और नॉट. इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट दैट टाइम इफ ही इज नॉट हैविंग द प्रॉपर कॉन्शियसनेस टू हैव अ फुल ब्रीथ. सो व्हाट विल यू सी द चेस्ट, यू नो द ग्लोव्स एंड एवरीथिंग. That is another part of this talk actually. Then it will become too long, how to deal with the trauma patient and all. So remove the clothes and see, just see the chest if there is any movement is happening. Or you can put your finger or whatever the sensitive part to see if there any air, you know, that transaction is going on or not.
अब हमने देखा कि इस पेशेंट का ना तो कैरेटेड पल्स फील हो रहा है और ना ही इसमें रेस्पिरेशन है. ठीक है, तो नेक्स्ट पार्ट हमारा होगा कि स्टार्ट द कार्डियक कंप्रेशन. फर्स्ट पार्ट क्या करेंगे हम, कार्डियक कंप्रेशन.
व्हाई कार्डियक, व्हाई नॉट ब्रीदिंग, व्हाई कार्डियक, व्हाई आई एम नॉट गिविंग ब्रीदिंग, वेयर आई एम मोर कंसर्न अबाउट ऑक्सीजन. जस्ट टेल देम टेल देम फास्ट. इज इट इजी यू You all can stand.
sequence I told you.
What is circulation?
Oh, yeah. I am more concerned about
circulation.
So for circulation, I want heart. So I go for heart. Yeah. Tell him how.
Next time. हमें हाथ पांव में रखने और कैसे रखने हैं। सबसे पहले ये जो हील ऑफ द पाम, आप कोई भी हाथ ऊपर या नीचे लेफ्ट भी रख सकते हो और राइट भी ऐसे भी कर सकते हो। इसमें जो आपका हाथ फोर्सफुल है वो नीचे रहेगा, ठीक है?
लेफ्ट और राइट हैंड, व्हाटएवर हैंड बी योर डोमिनेंट हैंड, यू जस्ट
पुट इट। और रखना है टू फिंगर्स अबव द जीफी प्रोसेस। यहाँ पे एक प्रोसेस रहता है सबके, यहाँ पे
सब लोग देखो अपने यहाँ एक हड्डी होती है विच इज एंडिंग, सो 2 सेंटीमीटर अबव दैट,
क्योंकि यहाँ पे टाइप का जम होती है इससे ऊपर, ठीक है? और हम हाथ कैसे प्लेस करेंगे? जस्ट दैट टू फिंगर, ओके?
कुछ नहीं फर्क पड़ेगा, हार्ट हैज टू गेट अ फुल पुश, इवन इफ यू आर नॉट, इफ यू आर टू स्मॉल, गिव अ मुक्का।
सब अपना सबसे हाथ कर लीजिए अपने अपने हाथ ऐसे,
सब ऐसे करिए, फटाफट करते जाइए, कुछ लो फटाफट,
ओके?
शो मी एवरीबॉडी हाउ इट इज
सिंपल। ओके, अब हम जाएंगे कंप्रेशन के लिए, ठीक
है? That how much it should go deep, your chest, tell me. 2 inches, this much. You should be able to press this much. The chest should go this much inside, then only that cardiac compression will be effective. So it is a big job.
30 compressions दे दिया आपने, ठीक है? उसके बाद second part रहेगा हमारा airway का. Airway में क्या देख रहे हैं? क्योंकि tongue कई बार roll out हो जाती है, पीछे roll हो जाती है. ऐसे करके roll हो जाएगी पीछे आपकी tongue, ठीक है? तो उसको क्या करेंगे हम? अगर हैंकर चीफ आपके पास या कुछ भी आपके पास है तो उसको ऐसे करके, जस्ट ऐसे करके इसमें अंदर डाल के,
कुछ नहीं उसके मुंह में हाथ डालना है, कुछ गंदा
कुछ गंदा है, टिश्यू वगैरह है वो बाहर ले
आना है, एनीथिंग इज देयर यू जस्ट स्वीप इट, स्वाइप इट ऑफ,
ठीक है? सेकंड हो गया एयर वे, ठीक है? थर्ड आ गया आपका ब्रीदिंग, ब्रीदिंग एक मिनट, ब्रीदिंग के लिए आपको क्या करना है? हेड टिल्ट,
ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है, ये सब लोग समझिए,
ठीक है?
कोई भी
गोल करना है और उससे क्या होगा, इसका एयर वे जो है बिल्कुल स्ट्रेट हो गया, आप देख सकते हैं बिल्कुल स्ट्रेट एयर वे हो गया। ऐसे करेंगे तो क्या होगा, ये थोड़ा सा ब्लॉक हो जाएगा, ऐसे
करेंगे कोई एक दिन आ जाओ
और उसको ठीक क्या करेंगे,
इसको लेकर
जैसे ये पेशेंट है अभी मैं क्या इसका टंग रोल खोलिए।
Now you can see this patient, Mukholi is not able to be, not able to speak to them. Nah? So you can see he is lying down like this. So doing this maneuver, what he is going to tell, how if he is a dead person, he is not going to resist. Because whatever we do, we can do it. So just stay. He is lying like this. So we put pressure here and we lift it like this. So by doing this only, it will open the chest. And half maybe sometimes they are able to revive with this.
अब third होगा हमारा breathing. 30 compression हम already दे चुके हैं, इनका air वे clear हो चुका है. Third है breathing. Breathing कैसे देंगे अभी हम? Just close the nostrils. इनका ये nostrils close करके.
सबसे पहले क्यों nostrils? Why we want to close nostrils? Where we are planning to do breathing? अरे अभी नहीं जाओ. Like water will come out from nose, so same way, the whatever air I am giving, it will come out from nose. So that will become a loop, they will not, it is not going to help his lung. I want the pressure, I want the volume, I want the air go to the lungs. So firstly, I have to pinch it. Okay? Then you open it like this. You just don't know, hey, if you are a dead person.
थर्ड है आप ब्रीदिंग देनी है हमें, ठीक है? सबसे पहले कि आपका ऐसे है, हमने कर चुके हैं, ठीक है? इनका ये नोस्टल्स क्लोज करके आपने इनका चेस्ट इंप्लेट होते हुए देखा है,
अभी आप देखिएगा हाउ मच आई हैव टू पुश एयर, यू हैव टू टेक डीप ब्रेथ योरसेल्फ एंड देन पुश, बिकॉज़ एवरी टाइम द वॉल्यूम हैज टू बी एट लीस्ट 50 टू 70 एम एल ऑफ एयर.
आपको दो रेस्क्यू ब्रीथ देनी है 30 कंप्रेशन के बाद.
30 वंस यू कंप्रेस देन गिव ओनली टू, यू यू डोंट हैव टू कीप पुशिंग एयर बिकॉज़ एयर पुशिंग एयर इज नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क इफ द हार्ट इज नॉट फुल. सो आई हैव टू कीप पुशिंग एयर इन बिटवीन जस्ट टू चेक व्हाटएवर कंप्रेशन आई हैव डन दैट हार्ट हैज स्टार्टेड फंक्शनिंग. इट इज जस्ट टू सी नॉट टू यू नो
और ये क्या
इट विल द हार्ट विल स्टार्ट वर्किंग ब्रेन विल स्टार्ट वर्किंग एंड
क्लॉथ इसलिए रखा गया है इन केस कुछ अगर सॉल्यूशन वगैरह कुछ निकलेगी तो वो आपके उसमें टच में नहीं आएगी, मुंह में नहीं आएगी.
थिन क्लॉथ व्हाटएवर यू आर हैविंग दिस यू कैन पुट इट ऑन देम
हैंडकरचीफ
इट इज टू थिन वी जस्ट हैव टू पुट इट ओके. सो एवरीबॉडी अंडरस्टूड
ब्रीदिंग हो गया 30 कंप्रेशंस टू ब्रीदिंग अगेन स्टार्ट सी कंप्रेशन 1
even sometimes more to break. Don't bother.
उसके बाद क्या कर रहे हैं जब 100 कंप्रेशन दे दिया एक साइकिल आपका हो गया है कैलोरी पल्स को चेक करना है
एवरी 100 यू हैव टू कीप चेकिंग अदरवाइज यू विल कीप डूइंग लाइक ऑलरेडी हैज हार्ट हैज स्टार्टेड ब्रीदिंग स्टार्टेड बट यू आर कीपिंग इट बिहाइंड एवरी विल गो टू
फॉलो. एक बार मैं पूरा साइकिल आपको बता देता हूं ठीक है उसके बाद आप लोग 5-5 के ग्रुप में आके प्रैक्टिस करेंगे.
तो ही ब्रिंग्स द पेशेंट टू पर्सन और द नेक्स्ट अप इज यस
फास्ट आर यू ओके आर यू ओके क्या आप ठीक हो
ठीक
है. सेकंड पर्सन को बोलो कॉल 108 और 102 जो भी एम्बुलेंस
आ रही है. लिसन ही इज लाइक यू आर वन ओनली ओके देन यू विल लाइक हेल्प हेल्प यू हैव टू शाउट विद योर फुल थ्रोट हेल्प 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 ओके 3 टाइम्स एट लीस्ट यू हैव टू शाउट अदरवाइज इफ पॉसिबल देन टेक इट हेल्प 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 जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस द स्टैंडर्ड प्रोसीजर
चेक फॉर पल्स एंड रेस्पिरेशन. No pulse, no respiration.
For every this job, you will get 1 second. You have to waste only 5 seconds for doing all this. Okay?
Okay.
The main job is to come to the...
No pulse, no respiration means patient required CPR.
Okay, this is 30. Now free.
30. Clear, Mary? Okay.
Don't explain
them now. Just keep moving. 2 times. Again CPR.
Understood?
Again
30.
Again same.
Are you okay? Help! Help! Check pulse.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
ऐसे
बस हेड इज गुड देन डोंट ब्रीथ ओके बट तो
एल्बो सीधा एल्बो सीधा रखिए हां ओके
आफ्टर 50 शी हैज टू ब्रीथ इट जस्ट या दिस इज द वे शी डिड इट वेरी राइट इनफैक्ट इट इज कमेंडेबल एवरीबॉडी शुड क्लैप फॉर हर. Understood? So, for again, this is the way. Next, fast.